In this video, we'll discuss how to use Manupatra for mood preparation. To start with, we'll understand what are the basics of preparing for a mood. The first and foremost step is understanding the mood proposition you have been presented with. The next step is to identify the applicable laws to your mood problem, whether it's a civil case, whether it's a criminal case, whether it has international and Indian jurisdiction both, what kind of a case it is, and similar issues. The next would be formulation of the issues, as in the most important law points that are being discussed, the key questions that you need to be answered from the court. That's why you're approaching the court. So that forms the basis of your entire moot court exercise. The next step is supporting your arguments with authorities. So the issues that you form, the questions that you raise, you want the court to favor you. So what are the arguments that you present the court with, along with what are the convincing authorities that you add? The judicial system is based on precedents as well as convincing power of scholarly articles, news reports, your arguments, what logic you present. So this is again the most important step, which is supporting your arguments with authorities. The next is finding these authorities. And by finding, I mean not just finding the cases that have discussed the same proposition or articles that have discussed or laws that contain those provisions, but also checking the credibility of them. It's a good law, whether a case has already been filed regarding the same issue and similar. The last is building your compendium. Again, building your compendium is extremely crucial because all this logic, all these facts, all these authorities that you present, their credibility is based on how good your compendium is, how authentic your sources are in your compendium. So this is all that we'll discuss in this video today. First and foremost, understanding the mood proposition. So the first important step is to read the problems and identify the relevant and irrelevant facts. So if it's a problem that discusses a lot about the family life of a particular individual who then commits a contract fraud, you have to sit back and evaluate what are the relevant facts that can be attributed to his behavior in the contract fraud, and what are the irrelevant facts that have nothing to do with it and have just been presented in the mood problem to make it full. If you make this distinction clear, you cut down the amount of material that you need to work in to understand your mood proposition better and subsequently frame your mood memorial, channel your arguments, build your compendium. Now, again, this helps you write the statement of facts. Whenever you're preparing for a mood, the first step is to make sure that you have the best statement of facts you can propose. Again, an overlooked step, but if done correctly, it gives you a lot of marks. Again, your statement of facts helps you in the formulation of issues, sub-issues, sub-sub-issues, how you logically take your argument from one point to the other. A bonus tip, the best way to present a statement of facts document is to present it in a tabular form. The best colleges in India and abroad, the best moots, propose this as the best strategy. Moving on, identifying the most applicable laws. Once you've identified your relevant facts, you have a general idea of what are the questions of law that you need to present, what are the issues that you have. On the basis of the issue, you need to identify what kind of case it is, what are the applicable laws, the statutes, the acts, the jurisdiction, where the case can be instituted, in which kind of a court. Then you can find the relevant law according to the subject matter. If it's a criminal law, you have to look at the IPC, the section that the offense comes in. But you also have to look at CRPC. You also have to look at the Indian Evidence Act. So this helps you identify all the applicable laws together that you need to apply, that you need to go through to prepare your moot memorial. Again, there are multiple applicable laws. So at times you'll see that, okay, in CRPC, there's a provision, but it writes that, okay, if evidence law has this provision, that would overrule. So identifying these particular nitty-gritties, these key points is also very important. There's a quick tip here, which is that Manpatra provides you legal taxonomy, which, you know, helps you find the relevant topics and subtopics and the top judgments in each category. So if you look at murder, you go through the sub-issues under it. Legal taxonomy would provide you that along with the top judgments on murder, which you can use our further tools like case map, cited in para, Manusai, to find the most recent judgments on these topics and issues. So please make the best use of it. Next is the formulation of issues. Now, this is the core formulation of issues, the core arguments that you put up, the arguments that you raise, the arguments that you explain, you advance, what your entire memorial is based on. Again, how can Manupatra help you in founding the best issues, the best framed questions? By using the different kind of searches. So we have options like search and results, proximity search. All these provide you options to go through layers from very small shortcuts to find the most relevant keywords that give you the most relevant results to your proposition that ultimately you can use in forming the issues that you need. Use these issues to structure your arguments then. So not only are these keywords important to framing your issues, but then you can make these your sub-issues and so on. How do you support your arguments then? You support your arguments with authorities. You have your skeleton ready of this is the issue. This is my logical argument. Now, how do I beef up my argument? Don't use judgments from particular courts. Suppose if your jurisdiction is Delhi High Court. Ideally, Delhi High Court is bound by the precedents of the Supreme Court as well as their own courts. However, in a lot of cases, there are important judgments from other high courts that provide a very strong persuasive value to a high court in another state. Make use of that. There are some district court judgments that are very, very relevant. Make use of that. International courts have declared and made really good observations on key issues that courts throughout the world take inspiration from. Include those authorities. Privy Council cases, they have never been overruled. They still are good law. You can find all these on Manupatra. Use them to beef up your argument in the most comprehensive way. Similarly, there are pending bills and ordinances. So when there's a case that is going on and there's a issue that you don't want to be discussed there, that your opponent has raised, or you want to raise an issue and you can beef it up with the argument that, okay, there's already a pending bill supporting that or an ordinance supporting that. There are law books, legal dictionaries, legal articles, work of legal scholars. So all these combined together, beef up your arguments, beef up your statement of authorities, your contents, showing that you have really worked hard on your memorial and the arguments that you are coming up with is backed by a lot of good, great research. How, like here are the some of the tips to find the most relevant judgments. So you can use the words and phrases that you use to search that have given you the most relevant results. Again, as I explained, use these to form your issues, your sub-issues, your sub-sub-issues. The Manu search interface in Manupatra provides you a Google search on a legal research database, a free text search. Then you can use the relevance algorithm, the relevance filter, the other filters to come up with the exact judgments that match your propositions to the T. Again, a very common mistake is that students take out judgments which have a sentence or a particular line that is matching to their proposition, whereas that is not enough. The statements, the facts of that case should be similar to your proposition. It should be taken as a whole. This is what Manu Search with its relevance feature helps you in. You can also filter these cases. You can set a case alert. Suppose you're preparing for a moot for 2 months. And you found cases on your proposition. How about a case comes a week before that supports your proposition or nullifies your proposition? How do you know about it without having to search over and over again? Set a search alert. It will give you all the relevant new judgments that come into your inbox. You can set a timeline and go about it very easily. What are the quick Manupatra features to help you research faster? One is using the one good case method. Find one relevant result to your proposition. It has sufficient features providing within it. Cited in para, it gives you the most relevant paras that the case has been cited in future judgments that you can look on and find the most recent judgment. You have the case map that provides you 20 cases going forward that the case has been cited in, as well as 20 cases that the case cites, the top 20 cases. And you can use them to go forward. Each case would, like if you select a case going further, it would again provide you the 20 going forward, the 20 judgments that have been cited in it, so that you can find the most recent, the most relevant judgment. Use features like legal analytics, as I just said, ManuCite, how many cases has this particular judgment been cited in, that provides you how good an authority a case is. Use judge analytics. There are, if you know that, okay, there's a particular judge that has given a judgment that your opposition is citing, you can use the judge analytics feature in Manupatra to find that, okay, that is the temperament of the judge. That is how he approaches cases. How strong, like, are there relevant opposition judgments that he has cited, and similars. Support your argument using the most recent legal technology backed by AI and NLP to form your judgments. Here are some of the shortcuts that provide you with how you can determine the credibility of an authority. The red flag, it shows that this judgment has already been overruled, so that you don't waste your time on a particular judgment. Now, overrule again means that the main issue that was raised there was overruled. So even if there were subsequent issues that were discussed or overruled or not overruled, the main issue that was in that case, that the case was about, has been overruled. Cited in para, you can get a ready listing of judgments. If there's a bill pending, if there's an SLP that has been filed for a case, so that you can take the argument that, okay, this court does not have to discuss this issue. It is already before a higher court. Similar shortcuts are provided at your fingertips on Manupatra, so that you do not have to read and go deep. You can just look at a particular icon and understand what it represents. Lastly, building your compendium. Now, with compendiums, judges always have that credibility issue. If you've cited a judgment, you can very well remove a word or add two words and include it as a typo error. And judges can be that, okay, this is not the real thing that was published or that the court said. Similarly, with your oppositions, you can always check that. How do you ensure that your compendium is completely credible? Use the Manupatra feature of print replica. You can get the original court copy from the court website through Manupatra. Also, when you're using articles or some other form of authorities that do not require that strict format of a judgment, you can use the display settings, save paper, format it according to you, highlight parts, bold parts that you need to show the judge. Moving on, here's a sample moot proposition that I'll show you the research on by doing it on the Manupatra website. So again, it is about a 22-year-old college graduate whose father passed away after contracting COVID, and now the family is going through a financial crisis. She has younger siblings and an ailing mother to care for. She needs a job now. Now, the issue is that can she get a job, as her father was a government servant who died in harness. She's also recently divorced and is under mental stress. So her plea has been rejected by the government. Now she has approached the courts to understand and to get some relief on account of her hardship and her father dying in harness. Now, how do we approach this case on the Manupatra website? First and foremost, we'll go through the proposition and understand the most relevant points, as I told in the first step. So what are the laws applicable? The laws applicable would be dying in harness rules as it comes from there, the Constitution of India, the right of a daughter to get a job, or to understand the hardships of the citizens of India. What are the key words for the relevant search? Now, when you read about dying in harness, you find that compassionate appointment is what is called giving family members jobs in places of their deceased employees. Divorced daughter. The daughter is divorced here, and that is one key factor on why she is not getting a job in the place of her father. Again, what are the relevant material that you can search on other than looking at the most precise judgments on this? That are daughter's right in family after marriage, whether women should have equal rights.